This is your last chance. After this, there is no turning back.
You take the blue pill. The story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe whatever you want to believe. You take the red pill. You stay in Wonderland, and I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes.
Where we go from there
is a choice I leave to you.
Welcome to the real world.
Back in 2009, I put out a video clip on YouTube called The Complete Fishing Kayak, and at the time I was showing it off set up as an outrigger. Since then, my setup's evolved quite a bit. I've added a bit of stuff and I've taken away even more. Here I'm showing it off set up as a trimaran. This is your genuine, no expense spared experiment. I've been playing around with this boat for a couple of years, and what I've come up with here I reckon is pretty much perfect for my needs. Let's start by looking at the stern of the kayak. Close inspection will reveal here I've got one of these bung to ram adapters, or balls of steel as I'd named them. I've heard other names for them as well. On that, I've got attached my transducer for my sounder, the cable of which is coming out through the hull underneath that little port right there. Here in the rear well, I've got a few things stored, including my wheel cart. Now, this is a custom made wheel cart made by Taztec Industries. We sort of worked together on this one and designed it to be what I thought was pretty much the perfect shape for the island. And I was thinking about storage just as much as I was durability and reliability, and it certainly serves all those purposes nicely. It's got fairly short posts. The idea of that is to make it easier to put the wheels in on the water, and I think that's actually pretty important on the island, especially when you're trying to launch or land in surf. I've done something a little bit different with the bungee cords in the rear storage well here. I've done away with the zigzag setup that comes by default, and instead what I've done is I've run a couple of separate bungees which I've made up as Oki straps along the sides, hooking up here through that pad eye there and up the end there, and I've got another separate bungee cord coming from underneath this pad eye through to that pad eye there. And the idea of that is to give me something to lock the wheels onto, something here that I can use as a spare leash if I really want to, and I've got bungees coming from out of these pad eyes here which can clip across to the other side, and running free along there are these stainless steel clips which I use to clip on to my tackle box and my safety box. Tucked away into this recess behind the seat is my water bottle, and this is a stainless steel bottle. It's a GSI duck jug, and they call it a duck jug because it's got this recess channel here which you can use to wrap some gaffer tape or duct tape around as an emergency backup. Not a bad idea at all. Underneath this silicone wrap here, I've also wrapped around about 10 meters of heavy duty leader line, which is a pretty handy place to have it. Hobie rod extender tubes are really nice on the island. They help to keep your reel high out of the water. I take extra measures to secure them to the hull. As you can see here, I've got this little stainless steel clip which runs free on that Oki strap there. And of course, I've got it leashed too. That's really important on the island. You've got to use a rod leash in these tubes. I'm using ram tubes to fish from. These are attached to the rear crossbar with a ram ball there. I've got one on each side, and I find these are very, very handy for trawling. It's a really good spot to do it with. You can rest your elbows here on the butt of the rod, and you can feel bites as they come. Of course, I've got the thing leashed. That's pretty important. The leash is running through this pad eye, through there and down, and I attach it to that pad eye there to secure the whole thing to the kayak. Just attached to the handle on the ram tube rod holder there is my priest or fish donger. Really like the new Hobie seat, the 2010 version. It's got the inflatable lumbar pad. I also use the inflatable eye comfort seat, and underneath that I've got a stick-on foam pad which really helps. It's a nice addition to make for a very plush ride. Attached to the right strap of the seat here, I've got this little Daiwa jig pocket, and I've attached it to use as a gimbal, actually, for when I hook really big fish. Rather than digging the rod butt into my groin, I can stick the rod butt into that and protect myself. At the back of my seat here is a seal line seal pack. I've attached this by getting clever with a couple of stainless steel buckles and whatnot at the back of the seat. And this is a really good dry bag, actually. It's very, very strong. It's easy to use, it's easy to get to. And in there, I store my radio, snacks, etc. I've got the shark shield here wrapped around the ram tube there. And it's a pretty good place for me to store it, actually. It's locked on there. It's actually held in place by this bungee cord there. It can't come off. And the antenna of which runs down and coiled up and inside the pocket on the tram. I have done some modifications to the back of the tram here. I've incorporated an Oki strap bungee cord at the back there. It's just done with a little hook attached to the webbing at each end. And the idea of that is to give me something to use to secure things to, like my fishing net here and also my paddle blade. I only use a single blade paddle when I'm on the island like this, and the handle of which is actually secured by this little loop of bungee cord that I've got attached through that eyelet on the tramp and hooked around that ram ball there. That helps to keep the tramp secure to the side of the boat and obviously keeps my paddle in place nicely. In under the 8-inch hatch here, I've attached this box which I keep spare lures that I like to keep out of harm's way. And in under here, I store a few separate things. One of them is a set of binoculars, digital SLR camera, which comes out for the money shots, a big drum bag full of extra water, just in case. I've also got a Hobie drift chute, or a drogue, which I find really handy for drifting. And also attached to this cord is my bilge pump, which if an emergency was to occur, would come in very handy. In the port side pocket there, usually where I store any soft plastic lures that I'm using, that's one of my favorites there. Lip grips as well, very handy to help dealing with fish, which I usually do on the tram there. That's attached with an attractable gear leash. And up front deck here, I've mounted an extra mesh pocket, which I find quite handy to store any extra lures on the fly. This is the Lawrence HDS5 sander that I'm now using. I got rid of the old hummingbird, didn't pass the waterproof test. This one's mounted also on a B-size socket arm there, and the cables of which are running through into the hull, power and transducer. I've got these spray skirts attached to the bow of the kayak now, and these are a nice addition. These are built by Holger. Very similar in design to a bunch of other aftermarket spray skirts that are out there. And this one I've modified quite a bit, actually, and I've done it to make it easier to fold in the pontoon. I rigged it so that instead of just looping each skirt out to these eyelets at the end, instead I've got an extra length of line that I've attached to that loop around the post, down to this ram ball here, through that stainless clip, which is also there to attach that to the kayak, and down around to the side pocket here, and that is in a jam cleat. Now the idea is that I can quickly pull that out, relax the skirt if I want, and that makes it very easy, very quickly, to fold in the pontoon. And then when I want to pull it tight again, all I need to do is pull it up and cleat it into position. Perched up on the bow there is my gaff hook. I keep that secured underneath those bungee cords there. Underneath the hatch here is where I secure or store fish. There inside the hatch is the big bag that I use, and inside the bag there, as you can see, are the fish.